You are listening to Daily Bread Devotions with Father Eustace Siame, a Salesian of Don Bosco. Your word, Lord, is a lamp for my steps. Stay tuned.
This is my daily bread. This is my daily bread. Your very word spoken to me.
In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
It is Monday, the 18th of July, 2022, 16th week in ordinary time. And participating in the proclamation of the Word of God for today are the following Daily Bread members. Sister Joyce Mboya from Mwanza, Tanzania, celebrating her birthday today, takes for us the first reading. Sister Jacqueline Etimbi from Port Margot, Haiti, celebrating her silver jubilee of religious life today, takes for us the responsorial psalm. Proclaiming the gospel is Father Evans Jefferson Ombaye, a Salesian of Don Bosco, working in Moshi, Tanzania, who celebrated his priestly anniversary on the 10th of July. Let us pray. Show favor, O Lord, on your servants, and mercifully increase the gifts of your grace, that made fervent in hope, faith, and charity, they may be ever watchful in keeping your commands. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, God, forever and ever. Amen. Our first reading.
He has showed you, O man, what the Lord requires of you. A reading from the book of Prophet Micah, chapter 6, verse 1 to 4, 6 to 8. Hear what the Lord says. Arise, plead your case before the mountains, and let the hills hear your voice. Hear, you mountains, the controversy of the Lord, and you enduring foundation of the earth, for the Lord has a controversy with his people, and he will contend with Israel. O my people, what have I done to you? In what have I wearied you? Answer me. For I brought you up from the land of Egypt, and redeemed you from the house of bondage. And I sent before you Moses, Aaron, and Miriam. With what shall I come before the Lord, and bow myself before God on high? Shall I come before him with burnt offerings, with calves a year old? Will the Lord be pleased with thousands of rams, with 10,000s of rivers of oil? Shall I give my firstborn for my transgression, the fruit of my body, for the sin of my soul? He has showed you, O man, what is good and what does the Lord require of you, but to do justice and to love kindness and to walk humbly with your God. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Responsorial Psalm, taken from Psalm 50, verses 5 to 6, 8 to 9, 16 BC to 17, 21 and 23. Response is taken from Psalm 50, verses 23 BC, and the response is: to one whose way is blameless, I will show the salvation of God.
To one whose way is blameless, I will show the salvation.
gather my holy ones to me, who made covenant with me by sacrifice. The heavens proclaim his justice, for he, God, is judge.
To one whose way is blameless, I will show the salvation of God.
I do not rebuke you for your sacrifices. Your offerings are always before me. I do not take more bullocks from your farms, nor goats from among your herds.
To one whose way is blameless, I will show the salvation of God.
How can you recite my commandments and take my covenant on your lips, you who despise correction and cast my words behind you?
To one whose way is blameless, I will show the salvation of God.
You do this, and should I keep silence? Do you think that I am like you? I accuse you, lay the charge before you. A sacrifice of praise gives me honor, and to one whose way is blameless, I will show the salvation of God.
To one whose way is blameless, I will show the salvation of God.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
A reading from the Holy Gospel according to Matthew.
Glory to you, O Lord.
Matthew chapter 12, verses 38 to 42. At that time, some of the scribes and Pharisees said to Jesus, "Teacher, we wish to see a sign from you." But he answered them, "An evil and adulterous generation seeks for a sign, but no sign shall be given to it except the sign of the prophet Jonah. For as Jonah was 3 days and 3 nights in the belly of the whale, so will the Son of Man be 3 days and 3 nights in the heart of the earth. The men of Nineveh will arise at the judgment with this generation and condemn it, for they repented at the preaching of Jonah. And behold, something greater than Jonah is here. The Queen of the South will arise at the judgment with this generation and condemn it, for she came from the ends of the earth to hear the wisdom of Solomon. And behold, something greater than Solomon is here." The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
We are on one of the most interesting passages in the book of Prophet Micah. Israel on trial before God. Israel has to be on trial because the cases have been too much. Israel has committed a lot of crimes. Israel has departed from the path of the spouse, God himself. Israel has chosen its own path, gone away from the one true love, God. And now the curse is going to be held on a mountain. It's interesting that the curse is only taking place on the mountain. Why not on the lower ground? Why not in the valley? Because our God is found on an elevated place. He is high up above. And so if you want to be like him, you have to go towards him, not him coming towards you. You have to go towards him. So on the mountain, be on an elevated place so that you are able to see where you have gone wrong. If you are in the valley, you won't be in a position to see where you have gone wrong. And so you go on the mountain. God invites Israel to come on the mountain and plead her case. Arise, plead your case before the mountains, and let the hills hear your voice. Hear you, mountains, the indictment of the Lord, and you enduring foundations of the earth. For the Lord has an indictment against his people. He has a case. He has presented his case, and I suppose the lawyers would frame it better than this. They would put it better than the way it is written here, because it is a formal case. It is a court case where God is the accuser and the judge at the same time. Interestingly, how can humanity win a case like this? He is the accuser and he is at the same time the judge. He brings the case against humanity, infidelity. Who can win? If you, O Lord, should mark our guilt, Lord, who would survive? But with you is found forgiveness, for this we revere you. Psalm 129. No one would survive. But we have a merciful and loving God who brings the case against Israel, explaining to Israel, I've done so much for you. I've taken care of you. I took care of you from Egypt into the promised land. What wrong have I done to you that you stray from my path? He's talking to you, my brother. He's talking to you, my sister. He's talking to me. I raised you. I made sure that you reached where you have reached right now. And if you look back, you went through a lot of dangers, but you are still here. What have I done to you that you're no longer worshiping me? What have I done to you that you no longer focus on me? We are all guilty. I plead guilty because there are many times that I do things as if he never existed. I plead guilty because there are many times that I go to bed without even thinking about him. I plead guilty. I plead guilty because there are those moments that I think is not awake when I go through a lot of things. I plead guilty. Yes, I know his judgment, his mercy and love. But pleading guilty helps me to take a new turn in my life and follow his path. Jesus is having a similar language in the gospel passage of today when he cries foul because of the way these people were unbelieving. They were demanding for a sign. We want a sign. Give us a sign so that we may believe in you. Jesus says, this is a wicked generation. I'm not going to give you any sign. The only sign I will give you is the sign of the resurrection. The sign of Prophet Jonah. Luke tells us about repentance in that sign, but the focus, the stress of Matthew is on resurrection. Just as Jonah was 3 days in the belly of the fish, so shall the Son of Man be 3 days and 3 nights in the belly of the earth. But was it really 3 days and 3 nights? He died on Friday and he rose on Sunday. We are not taking things literally. We want to look at the symbolic number 3. 3 days, 3 nights, meaning completely in the earth. And then he came back after being completely dead. He tells them that is a miracle you are going to experience. But I want you to make use of my presence to change, to transform. And so he says, the men of Nineveh will rise up at the judgment with this generation and condemn it. For they repented at the preaching of Jonah. And behold, something greater than Jonah is here. A call to repentance. The first reading is a call to repentance. When men wanted to plead and say, okay, I accept, I am guilty. And now what is the sentence you are passing and how much should I pay? I want to be on police bond. So should I bring bulls? Should I bring my firstborn child? Sacrifice. Are you interested in sacrifices? He said, no, I don't want all that. I cannot be appeased by anything that you give. All I want is that you live in justice. You do justice and you love kindness. And walk humbly with your God. That's all. I want you to change. I want you to transform. Just like the Ninevites did. Just like the Queen of the South got transformed by the word of Solomon. I want you to be transformed when you listen to the word of God. That's all. If you plead guilty, you know you've not been thankful to God for everything he has done in your life. Live your life well. That's all the Lord is asking of us. We give glory to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit.
As it was in the beginning, is now, and ever shall be, world without end. Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
And may Almighty God bless you, the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Blessed Monday to you.
Thanks be to God.
This is my daily bread. Your very word spoken to me. And I my day.